Ben, lots happening. Big players that were well established in advanced TV and the ad serving, header bidding, supply side. How do you guys, what's your position and tell us about the progress and kind of where you sit.
Sure. So Publica is a connected TV ad serving platform. So what that means is we provide a set of tools to publishers, connected TV publishers, to help them monetize their inventory in the most optimized way. And there are certainly a lot of players in the video sell side of the industry, right? I think the big difference with Publica is we built all of our technology for the sole purpose of maximizing publishers' revenue on connected TVs. And to do that, we had to build very specific CTV-centric products. So the first one is we included unified auction at the very core of our ad server. So what that means is, traditional ad servers use some type of a hack in order to include header bidding and auctions between SSPs, where you're going to have key value pairs that are targeted, line items, and so on. When you build an ad server from scratch, in the past few years, we were able to include that programmatic first idea at the very core of our technology. So essentially, we're able to support any type of business, whether it's a publisher that wants to sell all of their inventory programmatically and have business rules around priorities, or if it's a mix of direct sales and programmatic, we're able to have all of that compete in different ways in order to support any type of business rules. So I think that's one of the key differentiators is we built with the concept of header bidding at the center of the platform instead of building a platform first and then trying to hack around it to create a unified auction.
So, tell us sort of what header bidding looks like and what it will look like. It's still sort of nascent to many of us, but how is it shaping up and where is it going and what's the value?
Sure. So header bidding, to put in simple terms, is simply an auction between SSPs. So in a traditional ad server, you have a waterfall where you have an SSP tag that's going to be in position one. If that SSP has an ad, great. If not, it goes down to position two, three, and so on. Header bidding gets rid of that waterfall. So it's kind of the evolution of the waterfall where you put everyone in competition at the same priority level. And the winner is decided based on the CPM that's being returned for that particular device. So it's essentially just an optimized way of running your decisioning. And at the end of the day, it creates higher revenue for the publishers. But it also creates a much more accessible inventory for all of the buy side, because instead of having to fight for a position in your waterfall, now you can simply just bid higher if you want to deliver your ad to a particular user. So it's really a great improvement for both sides.
So Ben, let's talk a little bit about ad serving, and we've been reporting on that, and it's not as simple as it sounds. And it seems that there's a problem with a lot of inventory that's coming through from the demand side. What are some of the challenges around ad serving and CTV, and what are you guys doing?
So the biggest challenge is the ad break, I believe. That's what is very specific to the connected TV space, and that most of the technology that exists today was not built for. And so what I mean by that is, if you're watching a show on a TV, whether it's a Samsung TV or a Roku device that you're plugged into your TV, when you get to an ad break, there's going to be multiple ads in a row that are delivered, right? We also call that the ad pod. So the very basic level of that is, at the very least, I don't want to see the same ad multiple times, right? I also don't want to see four car commercials back to back. That's neither good for the user nor for the advertiser. So that's kind of basic level. But if your ad server wasn't built with those use cases in mind, it's sometimes very difficult to achieve, which is why you today, still to this day, you see some of the largest programmers, the largest publishers in our industry, they're delivering back-to-back ads or the same or different car commercials, but in the same ad break. The next level, which is a bit more advanced, is looking at the session as a whole. So let's say you're able to do the deduplication within the break. That's great. But now you don't, also don't want to show the same Toyota ad 10 times within the same, you know, within a game or within a TV show, for example. So at that point, you have to think of, how do I optimize my session? And how do I deliver the highest yielding ads in the place in my show or in my game where it's going to yield the most revenue and ultimately have the highest impact for my advertiser? So that's something that at Publica we thought of immediately when we created the product. And today we're able to say, well, even in a live stream, this is the third ad break that this user gets to. They've already seen X amount of car ads. They've already seen these advertisers. And so we are able to optimize at the session level, because the goal obviously is to maximize revenue, but also to deliver a TV level user experience. And then I think our vision for that, which is kind of a level beyond advanced, which I think I would call the God mode of ad pod optimization, is to be able to combine everything that the AI does. So everything that we do in the back end to optimize for ad delivery, for price, for user experience, with business strategies. So you're going to want to be able to say, okay, if I have a user that joins my stream past halftime, for example, so they've missed the bulk of the ad inventory and where the highest yielding ads are delivered, I still want to be able to target them with that high CPM campaign, even if it's in the third quarter, for example. And so that's the kind of things that we always work on. And frankly, we're still working on every single day, is to mix, how do the algorithms work with how do the business strategies work, and try to bring those two together in the most efficient way.
And Ben, finally, just tell us a little about the roadmap. I mean, we'll love to speak to Cedric sometime. Tell me a little bit about the crew and you know, what the plans are and the roadmap sort of in the States and globally, and you know, where Publica is headed.
Sure. So Publica is a Silicon Valley startup that we created a little over 4 years ago now with my co-founders, Cedric and Naban. We've since quite outgrown our startup house here in Palo Alto, and we are now over 20 employees worldwide in LA, New York, London, and Paris. And really, we're just trying to keep up with our customer base. I think we've had the chance of having strong customer adoption, particularly this year where the CTV marketplace has been booming. And today we are really staffing up to support that customer base. In terms of roadmap, there's a few items that we think are absolutely essential. So obviously continuing to develop our ad serving tools and features. But the other two aspects that I would probably mention is one, audience enablement. So we, through a partnership with LiveRamp, we're able to bring people-based TV advertising today to our customers. And what I mean by that is really the ability for publishers to sell audiences at an extremely granular level to any advertiser, whether it's programmatically or direct. And really the opportunity that excites me the most here is, obviously we have the traditional TV dollars that are shifting to the connected TV space. But even what I find even more exciting is that really by enabling people-based advertising in TV, we're also going to be able to attract dollars from the social media platforms. Because if you're able to target, you know, people based on their political views, for example, which is we've seen a lot of these past few months and on our platform, and if you give the advertisers the choice of delivering that ad in a user-generated newsfeed or in the largest screen of the house in premium content, I think the advertisers are going to choose the TV screen all day. So really, that's the opportunity that we see, and we want to continue to build the tool sets to enable people-based TV advertising at a much larger scale. The second opportunity that we find extremely exciting is more relative to streaming. So when you insert an ad in a connected TV, you usually do so with an SSAI solution. And Publica has built its own SSAI solution. And our specificity is that it is built for programmatic advertising. And what we think is the opportunity here is that the more the server that is responsible for delivering the ad, the more that server can interface with the programmatic ecosystem in order to pass the right values, to also activate the proper measurement, whether it's, you know, fraud or invalid traffic, things like that, to be able to give those guarantees to the buy side, and then to deliver the ad experience that a user is expecting on TV, then I think it's going to really help take this industry to the next level in terms of ad spend on the, in the connected TV space. So we're working a lot on that, and solving some of the basic problems that still aren't solved today, like prefetching in the VOD space. So a lot of SSAI servers today prefetch hours and hours of content with ads that never end up making their way to the user, which inflates inventory and also decreases credibility in that inventory. So those are some of the key features that we're working on solving with our partners. And we think that being able to address them is really going to help the industry evolve as a whole.